India is going to be free of incandescent bulbs, and CFL use has already become minuscule. We will use the approach of Mission LED bulb method to promote the use of solar stoves and battery chargers in the country. To make railway travel a pleasant and satisfying experience to the common citizen, again, ease of living, we will launch a massive program of railway station modernization this year. Railway station modernization will be launched this year. Honorable Speaker, sir, I draw the attention to the women of India. Nari to Narayani. We believe, obviously, this country's tradition has been Nari to Narayani.
Swami Vivekananda is going to be in a letter of Swami Ramakrishna Ananda says to the common citizen.
There's no chance for the welfare of the world.
We will launch a massive program of railway station modernization.
I repeat, this year.
There is no chance for the welfare
modernization.
Unless the condition of women is improved. It is not possible.
Honorable Speaker, sir, I draw the attention.
It is not possible for a bird to fly on one wing. Swami Vivekananda's words, this government believes that we can make progress with greater women's participation. In India's growth story, sir, I would like to draw your attention. In India's growth story, particularly in the rural economy, Grameen Arthvyavastha mein, the role of women is a very sweet story. Grameen Arthvyavastha mein mahila ki bagidari ekdam ek sunera kahani. This government wishes to encourage and facilitate the role of women. Gender analysis of the budget aimed at examining the budgetary allocation through a gender lens has been in place for over a decade. I propose to form a broad-based committee with government and private stakeholders to evaluate and suggest action for moving forward. There is no segment of human life where the contribution of women is not significant. There is no segment where the contribution of women is not significant. This government firmly believes that the socio-economic transformation that is taking place, particularly in the last decade, India's women's role and leadership is distinct. The recent elections have shown record turnout of women voters at par with men. Record turnout of women voters at par with men. We also have a record number of 78 women MPs here in this house. This reinforces our approach of going beyond just women-centric policy. I repeat, this reinforces our approach of going beyond just women-centric policy making to building women-led initiatives and movements. This government, Speaker Sir, has supported and encouraged women entrepreneurship through various schemes such as Mudra, Stand Up India, self-help group support and so on. In order to further encourage women enterprises, I propose to expand the Women SHG Interest Subvention Program to all districts in India. Furthermore, for every verified woman SHG member having a Jan Dhan bank account, for every verified woman SHG member having a Jan Dhan account, an overdraft of 5,000 shall be allowed. Again, one woman in every SHG, which is spread all across the country, one woman in every SHG will also be made eligible for a loan up to 1 lakh under the Mudra scheme.
Speaker, sir, at the beginning I did tell you about India's soft power. India's soft power, which is the next section I'll concentrate on, India's soft power is appreciated in so many different ways. Some simple examples, sir. In the last 3 years, on the International Yoga Day, yoga has been practiced in large